Pan-African Parliament and the African Union having sleepless nights on how to end wars on the continent. The AU Commission on Peace and Security presented a gloomy picture, with the war ravaging South Sudan taking center stage.
The PSC stresses the need to ensure an urgent and effective cessation of all hostilities, which will create the necessary conducive conditions for the implementation of the outstanding and pending aspects of the peace agreement. There is no indications that the fighting will end anytime soon.
The PAP says the strife will not end if South Sudan leaders continue to put personal interests ahead of the nation.
The growing number of displaced persons in camps continue to serve as a breeding grounds for various armed groups. Further to this, combating approaches by regional powers on how to address the problem is also frustrating efforts underway, Mr. President.
Every problem that is in Southern Sudan spills over to Uganda. Every insecurity, every instability, all the influx of immigrants, every encroachment of the economy, the little economy of Uganda, whatever is happening in Sudan encroaches on Uganda. And this is why I'm saying that as Uganda, we are suffering the same way the Sudanese are suffering equally.
The Legislature's Committee on Cooperation visited Juba last month on a fact-finding mission. South Sudan blames the rebel leaders for failing to be part of the national dialogue in Juba. Meanwhile, a motion calling for the lifting of the U.S. ban on citizens of Chad from entering the U.S. was adopted. Washington accuses Chad of failing to share information on activities of Al-Shabaab terrorists in the region. Muntlingeni Dipoku, SABC News, Midrand.